Yes, dear students, in the last class we have studied about distillation of invisible liquids, and that was easily explained by a process called steam distillation process. So invisible liquids, how they are going to be separated, how they are distilled, we have studied in the last class. Today we are going to study the next topic, that is solubility of partially miscible liquids. This can be easily explained by phenol water system. Listen, phenol and water are partially miscible with each other at ordinary temperature. That means when you shake phenol and water, shake well, and if you see, the two layers are separated. They form a heterogeneous phase and there will be turbidity appears. That means they are partially miscible with each other or immiscible with each other, so to say. See what happens. When we shake phenol and water, there are two solutions obtained. One is the solution of phenol in water and a solution of water in phenol. And these two solutions are termed as conjugate solutions. So therefore, there are conjugate solutions. They are formed, such solutions are formed of different composition coexist with one another. They are called conjugate solutions. Okay, see, the mutual solubility of such solutions slowly increases with raising temperature. Okay, their solubility or their mixing capacity goes on increases with increasing temperature. And at a particular temperature, what happens? Both the solutions are completely mixed with each other. They are completely miscible with each other, and they appear as a single liquid. It is usually appears in the experiment as turbidity disappears. It becomes a clear liquid. It becomes a homogeneous phase. Okay? So what happens in the case of phenol and water system? As the temperature slowly rises, the two solutions, the two mixture, that is phenol and water, becomes completely visible. The temperature at which the phenol and water are completely miscible with each other and they become homogeneous solution, that temperature is called critical solution temperature. Critical solution temperature. It is simply called as CST, or it is also called consolute temperature. This critical solution temperature or consolute temperature is different for different immiscible liquid pairs. Okay? At different temperatures, different mixtures become visible. For example, in the case of phenol water system, at room temperature they are invisible. When temperature slowly increases, visibility increases. At a particular temperature, they become completely miscible with one another. This is called critical solution temperature. This critical solution temperature for phenol water system is 68.1 degree centigrade. This is the CST of phenol water system. Okay, this can be easily explained by using the graph. When we draw the graph of phenol water system, by taking miscibility temperature in the y-axis, miscibility temperature in degree centigrade in the y-axis and percentage of phenol in the x-axis, what happens? We get a curve like this. Okay? The maximum point is called CST. In the case of phenol water system, it is 68.1 degree centigrade. And the corresponding composition is called critical solution composition, and the percentage of phenol is found to be 36.10% of phenol. See, the critical solution temperature for phenol water system is 68.1 degree centigrade and critical solution composition is 36.10% phenol, remaining 63.90% water. So in this composition, at a temperature 68.1 degree centigrade, the phenol and water will become completely miscible with each other. So this is the critical solution temperature of phenol. See, when we look at this diagram, any composition under this curve will become immiscible. Below this 68.1 degree centigrade, all the composition of phenol and water are completely immiscible. They will not mix with each other and they will become heterogeneous. See, when temperature 68.1 degree centigrade is reached, phenol and water will become homogeneous. They become completely miscible with each other. They act as a single liquid, it becomes homogeneous. Another thing, above 68.1 degree centigrade, all the compositions of phenol and water are completely miscible above the critical solution temperature. This is also called upper critical solution temperature or absolute temperature, because above which all the compositions of phenol and water are completely miscible. There are some liquid pads, immiscible liquid pads, in which their miscibility increases with decrease in temperature. In such a case, we will use LCST, that is called lower critical solution temperature. That is for different liquid pads, but it is not given in your syllabus. In your syllabus, only UCST is given, upper critical solution temperature is given, which is observed in the case of phenol and water system. Say, below 68.1 degree centigrade, all the compositions of phenol and water becomes invisible. They are heterogeneous. They show turbidity. They will not show clear liquid. They will not mix with each other. They will appear as two conjugate solutions. Above 68.1 degree centigrade, whatever may be the composition of phenol and water, all the composition of phenol and water are completely miscible with each other. They act as a single phase homogeneous clear liquid. Okay, see, this is called critical solution temperature that can easily explain for phenol water system. Next topic we are going to study in continuation with this, a very important topic is effect of impurity on CSD. Okay, effect of impurity on CSD. That means in the case of phenol water system, if we add a third substance which act as an impurity, then in that case how critical solution temperature varies, how it differs, that is what we are going to study in this topic. Okay, now if I take phenol water system, if the added impurity I am considering as sodium chloride, if sodium chloride impurity is added to phenol and water, this sodium chloride is soluble in water but insoluble in phenol. Insoluble in phenol. What happens to the CSD? Critical solution temperature. See, the added impurity is soluble in one of the component but insoluble in another component, that is sodium chloride soluble in water and insoluble in phenol. In this case what happens? The CSD increases. CSD increases. See, when the added impurity is soluble in any one of the two liquids, then what happens? The critical solution temperature increases. Similarly, for example, if I add impurity like naphthalene, if I add naphthalene, what happens? The naphthalene is insoluble in water but soluble in phenol. Exact reverse. So here, when the added impurity is insoluble in water and soluble in phenol, then in that case also critical solution temperature increases. Okay, then we will study the next case. For example, if the added impurity, for example, if I add urea, what is urea? Diamine. If urea is added to the phenol water system, what happens? It is soluble in both. Soluble. Urea is soluble in both phenol and water. In this case, what happens to the CSD? The CSD will remain constant. Will remain unchanged because the phenol, that is the urea interaction with both the solvents, phenol and water equally, therefore the CSD remains constant. See, when we study the effect of impurity on CST, if the added impurity is soluble in any one of the solvent or in any one of the component, the CST, critical solution temperature, increases. If the added impurity is soluble in both the components, then what happens? The critical solution temperature remains constant. So today we have studied the solubility of partially miscible liquids. We have studied phenol water taken as an example. So in the case of phenol water system, we have studied critical solution temperature. Critical solution temperature is the temperature at which the immiscible liquids becomes completely miscible with each other and they become homogeneous and act as a single liquid. Okay, and it is also called critical absolute temperature. Okay, and we have also studied the effect of impurity on CST, how the third substance added will affect the critical solution temperature of phenol water system. So with this topic, the unit will become end. So unit 1 solution is over with this topic. So dear students, now it is your duty and your responsibility to study all the topics of this unit in your home regularly and periodically. So I already told you, you please follow the principles of physical chemistry by Puri, Sharma and Patania. It will cover this whole syllabus. Okay, in your home daily you prepare for examination, you read, write and write, practice every day, then only it will be written in your minds, then only you will be able to write examination without any interruption. And in the next class, we are going to enter into the next unit, that is phase equilibria. Okay, so physical chemistry is not a so easy subject. Dear students, please remember, you have to work hard. Okay, now I have completed the unit 1. All the topics I have done. So it is now your duty to go through each and every topic, go through the book, prepare the notes, and try to understand the concept, okay, again and again, so that it will be retained in your mind. Okay, the next topic or the next unit we will study in the next class, and after that I will also give you some assignment questions. For that questions, you have to prepare the answers as an assignment and you have to submit in the Google Classroom itself. Okay, we will see you at the next chapter, the next unit in the next class.